No, kombucha will not heal your gut, but it is a healthy alternative. Let me explain what's going on behind the scenes, because I've seen too many people, spend hundreds and hundreds of dollars on probiotic pills and probiotic drinks like this, like kombucha. This doesn't even really have a name to it. It's just a sparkling rose fermented drink. But I've seen just too many people literally spend thousands of dollars on probiotics and, sauerkraut, just not tasty foods, things like that, and they still have a messed up gut microbiome. Meanwhile, their friends and family are eating literally whatever they want. They don't have any probiotics. Some haven't been breastfed. They're eating antibiotics like crazy, yet they still have zero digestive issues. Why do you have digestive issues and you've been doing all these probiotics and they have zero digestive issues? And they have been abusing their gut. What is going on here, guys? What is going on here? Well, it's obvious to say that for some reason, the good guys in here, the bacteria and fungi in here that are labeled good, they're not sticking, they're not staying around in our gut. Look, you have to understand where it comes from. So everybody who has, IBS, Crohn's, or colitis, if we look in their brain, we look at their CT scans, we're going to see a ring-shaped formation in the brainstem. And this tells us that their gut is in overdrive. Everyone who has Crohn's and colitis will have this ring. The people who do not have Crohn's and colitis will not have this ring. That is the 100% factor that we are looking for. And now, what this means is that this person experienced a conflict shock, a stressful situation, and they experienced it as something hard to digest. I can't stomach. That person makes me sick to my stomach. Something along those sort of lines. This whole situation makes me sick to my stomach. I can't digest this. What does our digestive system do? It digests things and it's controlled by the oldest part of the brain. It does not know the difference. It's a lizard brain. It does not know the difference between a piece of food that is inside of us and something passing through our lives. It's in all of our languages. And when we experience something stressful, one of our organs, it's a split second decision. I mean, just seconds, your life can end just like that. So your body's got to act fast. Something stressful happened. Oh my God, what am I going to do? The body makes a split second decision and says, okay, this organ can probably help us out. It seems like it was designed for this job. Let's put it into action. Let's put it into overdrive. And so you experience something hard to digest. I can't stomach this situation. Oh, looks like you need help digesting the situation. Extra gut cells. Here you go. You're gonna start accumulating extra gut cells. If you've ever gotten a colonoscopy and you have polyps, that's them right there. Those extra gut cells, they produce extra digestive juices. They have more absorptive area, so you can better digest this food, better absorb it, and create more digestive juices to digest it. But then when this situation gets resolved, you break up with a girlfriend, you make up with a girlfriend, you get along with your parents, things like that. Then it gets resolved. It gets resolved, and you no longer need these extra gut cells, and you start to get rid of them. And then that's when the fun starts. That's when you get the bacteria and the fungi, you get the dysbiosis, you get the blood, you get the mucus in your stool, you get the gut pain. We start to blame foods. We start to perceive these foods as hard to digest, and which starts the program. And when we're going to be constant, there's things called tracts, which remind us of these conflicts, which will activate this cell proliferation, the cell growth, and then when it gets resolved, it just turns into this crazy cycle because we get caught in these bad emotional habits. And so, where do these bacteria and fungi come in? These bacteria and fungi come in to help you break down these extra gut cells that we no longer need. I know that sounds crazy, but it's the only explanation that explains like why they go away once the conflict is completely resolved, and you see it on the brain scans, and the wound in the brain has completely healed. That is when the bacteria and the fungi will completely go away. People who don't have any hint of trauma, you know, they have a perfect gut microbiome, even though they abuse the crap out of their gut, you know, not doing probiotics and eating antibiotics like they're candy. This is the real world. This is the world we are not shown. That's actually, we're just making stuff up with statistics in modern holistic medicine, and we need to wake up, and we need to start following down paths, you know, making conclusions off of things that are correct 100% of the time instead of, you know, flipping a coin, because that's what we're doing right now. We're just flipping a coin, 50-50. We're making decisions off of things, whether it's 50-50. So, guys, I have an hour-long video where I show, guys, I literally drank kombucha like every single day for like years, and it never fixed my digestive issues until I got my emotional issues under control. And I'm going to show you how I did that in my hour-long video. It's an hour-long video. It's at the end of this video, and all you got to do is click on it, and I'll show you exactly what I did and what my students did to get their emotional issues under control so we can like literally eat whatever they want. I gained like 30 pounds this year. I want to show you guys how to do that. It is easy. Guys, go down and leave a comment below. I'm going to be making a video a day. I want to get your ideas on what you want to hear. I'm about to start doing a lot of research on how to address certain emotional issues. I'm starting to see a pattern that it usually falls down into anger, you know, parent issues, family issues, spouse issues, career issues. You know, these are like the most common issues that I see people running into. So I'm coming up with a guide on how to healthily address these issues so we can have our Crohn's and IBS and colitis be gone for good. Guys, it's possible. I want to show you guys how to do it. And it starts, your brain controls everything in your body. If you don't take anything else away from this video, your brain controls everything in your body. And your brain is, it's influenced by your psyche, your thoughts. And your thoughts kind of filter through this primal programming in your brain, which is going to affect how our other organs and tissues are going to react to the world around us. That's the thing I want you guys to start understanding. You need to realize that your body is more bacteria and fungi, so of course your brain has some control over the bacteria and fungi in your body. And if most of the bacteria and fungi in your body live in your gut, of course, your brain has control over that. So guys, good luck healing, and leave a comment down below. I'll answer your questions. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.